Hey everybody, DJ Professor Lee here, and boy, what a busy weekend it's been. What a busy month it's been, and finally got around to recording a video that I've been wanting to do for a while. So I hope you enjoy it, and here we go. So this video is in response to a post that was put up on the official Facebook page for a virtual DJ, and the question or the topic was in two parts. The first part was, is there a piece of software that you could use to be able to edit your songs or a track to have that song start at a place other than the beginning of the song? And the second part was, is there a software that you can use to edit out certain portions of a track? And of course, the answer is yes, yes, yes. And a number of different software products were mentioned. Audacity was one. It's a great program. I've used it. If you have the time to experiment with it, I highly recommend it. I think it's free. But if you're like me, you're very busy. One of the things you can do is you can use Virtual DJ and use the hotkeys as a way of doing that, along with your POI editor. So let's take the first part of it. If you want to start a track other than, say, the beginning of the song, go into your settings or config, depending on which machine you're using. Go ahead and scroll on down to options, open up options, where you see audio, click that. And if for some reason you can't see all of this or your screen looks vastly different than mine, that means you may need to check this box over here. And that'll give you a lot more options in terms of showing you the advanced options. But once you're here, scroll down to where it says Auto Cue. Click that. You can see mine is already set to Cue, which is my preference. And over here, you have a drop-down menu. Pull that menu down. And if you leave that set to No, then Virtual DJ will load your song onto a deck. It won't do anything to it. It'll be just the same as if you physically took a record and placed it on a turntable. Nothing happens. It just sits there. So who knows where it's going to pick up the music, but it's probably not going to be where you want it. So if that doesn't matter to you, your bedroom DJ, then go ahead and do that. If you want to skip the portions of your music that you know happen to be processed, but there's nothing audible that you can really enjoy, then Virtual DJ will skip that as well. You can also have Virtual DJ start on the first beat of the song or the track. Maybe you mix a lot of house music, a lot of EDM. Maybe you mix other genre that has a very consistent beat right from the very beginning of the song. Then this may work for you as well. As I mentioned, my preference is cue, because setting the cue for me is part of my convention for making sure my tracks are what I called groomed. So, for example, I've got two copies of the same track here. This particular one has been groomed. So I know that rating sign for me tells me that at a minimum, this track has had the first cue set at what I would consider the first danceable beat of music. That's how I use my rating. This doesn't mean this is a bad track, it's a good track, just means that it has eyes on. And then I start doing some additional things, like I'll add color to it, I'll do some other things like that. I'll put it in certain folders. That's all part of the grooming process, all right? So think of groomed as track is ready to go. Just like before you go out of the house, you know, you've brushed your teeth, you've combed your hair, you are groomed, you're ready to go. So, if I load this track onto my deck one, you'll notice the song loads right here. It's right on the line. Well, it turns out that's actually the first, what I recognize as the first danceable beat of the music, and I've set a cue point for it. It shows here, so I can turn it on, turn it off really easy. And there's a flag right over here. That's my first hot cue. Over, I don't have a hot cue to set because I mix a lot of Latin music, a lot of salsa, and oftentimes those songs have a stronger beat on the one or the two. So depending on the track that I'm bringing in, I might use one or the other of those beats. So for this particular track, it's not a salsa track, so I don't have. I'm not using cue two. You could use it if you want, but I'm not using it. Instead, my Q3, I'm using that as kind of a marker that something's going to happen, a marker that I either want to activate a loop there or I want to do something else. In this case, for my demonstration purposes, I wanted to show you that if I didn't have this queue, this hot queue set right here, and this was the only queue that was set, or these two, then the track would load here. So if I have a wedding and this is where they really want to come in, you know, or they wanted to start at this kind of area right in here, I just load a track at the beginning of that and that's it. Or maybe they want to skip everything here and they wanted to only dance to the last or walk into the last minute of the song. Put a cue point in right there. Make sure this cue point doesn't exist. Make sure this one doesn't exist. That's it. The song will load wherever you want. So you don't need to cut up your track. You don't need to record your track. Don't need to make copies of it. When you're done with that wedding or that event, you just, if you're never going to use that song in that way again, it's up to you, but you can just go ahead and delete those at that point. Yeah, so it's no big deal. The second part, what if you wanted to edit this track? What if there's a problem here? And that's what I've basically done with these two cue points. If you look at this song, there's a breakdown right about here, and then the song gets in here somewhere, and it starts to break down again. But look how long the breakdown goes. I'm going to load my second copy of the track, which is not groomed. And you'll notice it did not load at the first danceable beat of music, which is fine, because I don't need it to. But here it is. Here's that area without any instructions from me. This is what would happen when Virtual DJ got to that point in the track. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 3, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, dance. So in terms of the dance universe, people who are dancing to that rhythm, maybe they're dancing with a partner, that's a killer. They wouldn't necessarily, unless they knew that song, they wouldn't know that that break was coming up and they'd think the song was over, or maybe you suck as a DJ that you would put that song there and people begin to leave the dance floor. So maybe you don't want that there. So use your hot cues. Basically, I've told Virtual DJ through the use of my POI editor, I'll show you in a minute, I've told Virtual DJ that when you get to this cue point, Hot cue three, jump to hot cue four. Basically, that's done through the POI editor. So you have to open up my dialogues. I've got various editors. I've got the POI editor, which stands for Points of Interest Editor. And on the left-hand side, you can see I've got on the one, because that's already set. You saw that. I also have a loop that's there. So if I want to bring the song in as a repetitive loop, I've got an eight-beat loop set already. But then I've got my Q3. Now, let me go back to hot Q1. Notice it's just labeled. I changed that label so it says on the one, so I know what it is. And it's a hot cue. That's just a load point. But hot Q3, I haven't changed the name of the label. I could change it to, you know, jump or something like that. But I've changed the type to action. Once I do that, that allows me to use the macro field to tell Virtual DJ what action I want it to take. In this case, I wanted to jump to Q4. And you don't have to be a computer expert to know how to use macros. Basically, Virtual DJ gives you a bunch of macros that you can use depending on what category you're in. I happen to use the go to queue macro, and then I picked number 4. Could be queue number 99, and Virtual DJ allows you to do that many. So basically, this is what you would hear if you were dancing to this track. The song would go along if you just watched the waveform. Skipped right over it. There again. Okay, so it's as simple as that. All right. Now, the only thing I'll say, though, is that if you're going to use this convention to edit your tracks, spend some time counting it out, making sure that you're actually making your transitions or your jumps on count, on rhythm. This particular track, I didn't really worry about that all that much. It works because it's a very consistent beat. But if you were doing this with a track that had a lot of vocals and rhythmical breaks and so forth, where people are actually dancing salsa or they're dancing you know, West Coast Swing or something like that, if you didn't come in on the right count, your phrasing was off, it just wouldn't sound right. So just pay extra attention to that. Let's see, one other thing that I want to mention here is if you decide that you would like to use this in some other program, maybe you want to, you don't use Virtual DJ, you use something else, but you like the editing features of Virtual DJ, all you have to do is, whatever skin you're using, there's always going to be a record area. Open up Edit, give your track a name, tell Virtual DJ where you want to save it, what format you want it in, MP3 or whatever, press record. Now, once you do this, you're going to have an opportunity to get out of this because you'll get a dialog down here that will say waiting for you to begin. You have time to close this window. You have time to kind of get yourself situated. Make sure you get your headphones all set if you're going to speak or whatever. And then hit play button on your controller or on your screen and it will start recording right from there. Okay, so once you've saved it to your desktop, all you got to do is just put it on a thumb drive or, you know, upload it to the cloud and you can use it in whatever software you use. All right. Now, if you'd like to learn more about these editors, the POI editor, definitely go onto the website, Virtual DJ website, and look up Adam Whitehall's videos. He's done some great videos and he's continuing to come out with more all the time. And also, if you use Virtual DJ 7.4, Chris Anson has also done a huge number of videos that I think you would find useful as well. All right, so I hope you liked this video. If you did like this video, go ahead and that's it for me. I'm DJ Professor Lee. I'm out.